viewers for the next stream of Ace Attorney. This is part of the second chapter. Okay, that was kind of awkward. I heard my voice again for like the 80th time. And always, as usual, Eric has to be here.
Well, that's... I give it a bit of zing, you see.
I don't know what you mean by that, but like, it's kind of essential. Anyway, alright, let's do this. I wonder how slow the text is gonna go. As usual.
Oh, I thought I wasn't going to voice her anymore. Okay, let me see.
Wait, you said you weren't?
Well, hello!
I don't remember ever saying that.
I thought I wasn't because... Never mind. Okay, let me...
I already heard it.
Ooh,
also,
well,
why do you keep making her say that? I guess you want me to hate more?
Because that's how I channel it. I have to say it in order to channel that voice.
I didn't expect anyone to visit me in such a dank place as this.
So you have to use furry vocabulary. Interesting. Alright. Anyway, let's go.
It's really quite moving. Nah. You stink, Roy. You stinking lawyer. I hope you die. Oh, my throat.
Probably will.
Have you come to laugh? Yes! Laugh at the fallen Miss May!
That's what you sound like when you talk to a dog.
No, I don't.
No, not really. There's something I wanted to ask. Your voice is not what?
My voice does not hurt when I talk to dogs.
No doubt.
Unfortunately, there is nothing I want to be asked.
Hold on, I'll be back real quick.
I'm gonna wait for him.
Whoa, what the fuck? That was scary. My controller just rumbled. I'm not sure if you heard that.
That's because she was rumbling the screen. I didn't even read that.
Wait, you didn't?
I did not.
Alright, let's see. Oh.
There's no log.
There isn't, but I do have the stream that's like... This is like a minute behind! It's like a full minute behind! Alright.
Let's say.
It says, unfortunately, there's nothing I want to be asked, but it's fine.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, here we go again. Hold on. Please, you're scaring the security guard.
Great. You wish to ask of me, then?
For starters, how did you get to be totally whacked? I know how. Of course.
She's a bitch, that's why.
I was gonna say something really sexist, but I'm not gonna do that.
Sexist pig.
How do I... Okay, there we go. Well, I wanna
but
see what
you
he
are
says.
The examined.
No, there's no check marks. An inch. Dang, he hasn't moved all this time? Or maybe he just doesn't want... Or maybe he just doesn't want to see a lot of women like Miss May.
Or maybe he just doesn't get to see a lot of women like Miss May.
That makes it even funnier. Wait, is it just...
get to see.
Is it just...
to learn to weed, Thomas.
Nah, that sounds funnier. Anyway, so... I just noticed that this is like a... projection for some reason. I don't know if you noticed it. There's like a border. Smile for
yeah,
the...
it's because that's the window.
That's all it has to say. Like this. Oh, this whole thing is a window.
Yeah.
I never noticed that.
At the detention center, there has to be like a barrier between us and the.
Oh yeah, because this person's locked up for something like that.
Yeah.
What are even present? Like, oh hey, here, I'm gonna rub this in your face.
Hey, guess what? Actually, I, really hate your guts. So get lost. Because, well, I'm not cooperating.
Thanks. I mean, I was kind of being a jerk with that one. What? What did you say?
Well, I feel like that's what you said regardless. Unless it's like something.
Alright, let's see. What? Once again. Wait, didn't I literally just... Whatever.
Yeah, but you didn't ask.
Why did you place a wiretap on Mia's phone?
Like that, it sounds so cold. So criminal.
For a second there, I thought she was gonna compliment him. I don't know why, just some weird part of him was. Hold on. Tapping people's phones is a crime, Miss May. Hold on, give me a second. Dude, this is terrible.
What the lag?
No. It's just, I'm doing something on my phone that's quote unquote very important.
Alright. Oh, and I suppose you learned that in lawyer school. Creep!
Possible to talk to. I'll probably just ask this one question and leave it be. Actually, I want to see the last one. About the man who stayed with you in your hotel. Can you tell me about him? Where is he? Come on.
Jose.
Kind of a joke. Maybe if I had something to get her to talk. I know some of the last genes were really quiet compared to me, so I'm gonna turn your volume up a little bit. Hopefully my ears don't burn though. Now this is the most interesting question. Say, why are you so angry? I mean, you don't look like a bad person. I mean, I feel like...
You were cut up there for a sec. Sorry.
Oh, that does...
What the frick? Why are you, like, really cutting out now? Eric, I can't hear you. Hello? Eric? Alright, I guess I'll just skip that one, then. Bottom? Can't tell. Does she have a thing against lawyers? Or just against them? Eric?
I think I'm good now. My computer's lagging.
Alright. I was wondering what was going on. Oh, goddammit. Now my screen is green on your end. Or not? Is it? Does the screen look fine? Eric?
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, what happened? Yes?
I guess my computer was lagging or something. I don't know why. I don't know.
Maybe you have too many apps open.
I have only Discord up.
That's very odd. But okay. Looks like Forensics is taking the day off today. Detective Gumshoe, nowhere in sight. The police really gave this place a working over. I doubt there are any valuable clues left. Suppose it can't hurt to take a look around, though. Old movie poster. Apparently, this was the first movie that made me cry when I saw that. I'll have to check it out. I think, is this just the same thing?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, let's see. We just... Mask. Yep, same thing. I already read all that. Alright. Seems weird that maybe this will become relevant a little bit later. Well, obviously we have to go here.
Wait, what? Something was weird about...
What?
Never mind.
Oh, welcome, sir. Quite the performance today, if I do say so myself.
Thanks. Sorry for putting you on the spot like that.
No, not at all, sir. Your efforts today can only help the Gatewaters rep, as they say.
Huh? Rep?
Yes, a reputation will swell as the hotel where the murderer used a wiretap. Can charge a premium for the room, of course. It would be great for business, sir.
Whoa. Miss May hasn't been charged with murder.
I, too, will become famous. The bellboy who brought the murderer
ice coffee. What's so funny? What?
Why do I feel like we're both stuck in the same bad dream? So, you are an honored guest. Please let me know if there's anything I can bring you.
Alright. What happens when I look in the cabinet again?
Huh?
There's still a screwdriver stuck in that drawer.
Oh, please leave that as it is, sir. That's the Drawer of Terror, hiding place of the murderers, wiretapping. It's set to become one of the most popular attractions here. This guy's serious, I don't believe.
Really? I'm surprised you haven't said anything in a while.
I don't know what to say.
Oh. It's fine. I don't see Glassman.
That and I'm like playing Hearthstone.
I thought you said you only have one app up. It's not.
I'm playing Hearthstone on my phone.
Okay.
Ah, I beg your pardon, sir. If you could please refrain from touching this. It's part of the decor called The Last Drink Before Murder.
Wow, this guy really wants to become famous, doesn't he? Yep.
We'll be famous. The talk of the hotel industry.
Nice weather again today. I can see the Fan Co. Law offices, of course.
Oh, yes. We plan to install a telescope in that window, of course. Totally not trying to creep you or anything.
That would be a breach of privacy. Oh, I see where my IP was lagging. ABG tune-up was running in the background.
I don't even know what that is! Just $5 will earn you 3 minutes of a view to kill.
Seems very interesting.
Just kidding, sir. Oh. By that look in his eyes, let's see if he's more serious.
Dang, this guy's becoming interesting now. A little bit.
Well, I mean...
What?
Murder is good for business. Well, by that I mean, like, dramatic events are good for business.
Hold on. What the fuck?
Well, if it was murder within the building, that would kind of be bad for reputation. But if there was a murderer in the building, that would be good. It attracts attention. Thomas?
Yeah, hold on.
Why does this keep happening?
What's wrong?
Stupid thing isn't working anymore. Anyway, so... what does he have to say? I wanted to ask you about the man who was with Miss May.
Oh, yes. He struck me as a real lady. If you'll pardon the expression.
Because he was a lady killer, wasn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Literally.
I knew it from the moment I saw him, sir. He and I are from the same ilk. We both carry the scent of danger.
That does not sound good for you. There we are. Told you. Just a second.
If you have a photo of that man, I'm quite sure I could identify.
This is, what was he thinking?
About Miss May. Oh, her? Sir, not to boast, but I knew the moment I saw her. She'd do it, I said.
Do what? I'm starting to think the most suspicious person is this guy.
Could you tell me about this hotel? Absolutely! And on that subject, I have an excellent idea. Colonel, this hotel is known as the Gatewater. I propose that we add a subtitle.
A subtitle?
The Gatewater Hotel. Murder Manor. Well, what do you think?
Sounds great! Whatever floods your tea set. That felt like a lot shorter than the other one. Well, I guess there's only one last place to go.
Ghostbug, and this painting is missing.
Huh, I'm surprised you already noticed that. I didn't even notice that until you said it.
Because I saw it in, like, the preview.
Well, I didn't even notice it there.
What looks like cross here? I can't. Maybe he's avoiding me for some reason.
Well, let's forget the obvious. Wait a second. Wasn't there a giant painting hanging on that wall? Yeah. Yeah. It was a painting of... I believe it was the bottom one. Not like it probably matters. Wasn't it? A very memorable painting, anyhow. Wait. I feel like, what's the point of that option? Seems really odd.
I remember that was a cowboy, I think.
Oh, so all of them were wrong then.
Okay. I think so. Oh, look, a picture.
What do you mean, a picture? Oh!
Yeah, on the desk.
An elephant. I think I already read all this.
Yeah, you did.
That's kind of weird why the dialogue is the same thing.
That's because that's because the objects are the same.
Okay, then how come when I went to the other room, there was like one dialogue different?
Because there was a different person in the womb.
Man, you got a word for everything, don't you?
I have to come back for everything.
Yeah. Well, at least you don't make, at least you don't defend...
What?
Really dumb things, I guess. I don't know. Like, my god, it's the most ridiculous thing ever. Okay. Mm-hmm. What's this? Old photos. There are two lying here. Something's been written in pencil in the backs. Is it? DL6 Incident Exhibit A. DL6 Incident Exhibit B. Let's take a look at these. I'm sure I've seen this person somewhere. Perhaps I'll borrow this photo. I'm sure no one will miss just one little photo. And it might be a valuable clue. I'll take it for now. How do you recognize that person? That person does not look familiar at all. Alright.
The clothing looks, familiar. It looks like, Maya's clothes. Kinda.
Oh, it's in my inventory. Interesting.
Yeah. I think this is yes.
You don't have to answer for me. You're not the one playing the game. If you would, this would be a little bit easier.
I know. I just remember that the butler wanted a photo of a guy.
I don't. I think I'll swap them. Oh, yeah, because my inventory is full. Oh, yeah, I remember now. No clues here. What? Oh, I clicked the wrong button. I didn't know you could do that. Okay.
Oh yeah, Murder Manor.
I thought it was just gonna go in like an 11th slot or something.
Maybe I'll... I don't know.
No, I don't...
It would look weird if you... I mean, I think you didn't take both of them because it would be weird if you took both of them or something.
Really?
Because... I don't know.
What the fuck? Okay, this has to be some kind of joke.
This?
No! This thing on my phone. This application I was using was just working earlier, and now it's not.
Oh.
It's not because my inventory is full, is it? 2. Take a look at this photo. That's him. Detective. I'm the lawyer. Oh! I know that. I just wanted to say, detective. It's, you know how it is. No. No. Without a doubt. Checked in with me, Miss April May. How about write an affidavit swearing that it's him? What'd you say it is?
Affidavit? No, I don't know what that is.
An affidavit. Let's wait here.
Yeah, have him write it.
Well, what would happen if I click the other option? Just game over? Well, sure. Why not? Yes!
Well, I'm sure...
I'm sure
you can talk...
What?
I'm sure you have the option to do it again in that if you refuse him.
Oh, you think it's like that. Okay.
Uh-huh.
I've always wanted to write an affidavit, sir. Henceforth, I will be known as the bellboy who swore the affidavit. Just hurry up and write it. Maybe it's like a reminder or something. Not even Miss May can flip them to this. Huh! Looks like you must be really fuming of rage at looking at this, Eric.
I mean?
There's more than 10 inventory slots.
Yeah.
Okay.
So?
I thought you would get angry because of that point earlier.
I said that it looks suspicious if you took both photos.
Jesus Christ, I have... Why do I still have the phone?
I don't know.
I know, I know. I mean, I know why, but like... It just seems really weird. There's like nothing else to do. I just realized.
Yeah, there is. Phoenix just said, present this piece of evidence to, May. Miss April May. Yeah, that one.
Uh-huh.
The affidavit.
Alright. I was like trying to figure out what button it was again.
You again? Can't you take a hint and stay gone?
What? She's not enraged? Interesting. Hey! The only reason why I'm back here is because you won't talk to me. Uh-oh.
Oh, it's my fault now. You don't just have spiky hair. You also have a spiky heart.
That doesn't. This case is done. I'm shaving my head. Why is that funny?
Don't do
it's
it.
It's not funny.
It's not funny. Did laugh.
Yes, not funny. Did laugh.
No, it's just you said. You said not funny. Did laugh.
I did say not funny. Did laugh. What up? Isn't that what you said? Anyway, time to shove it in your face. Could you have a look at this? I'm gonna pretend that's what you said. The bellboy's affidavit. It tells us everything he saw.
Affidavits.
Whatever. I don't really. I've never heard that. Such as the man you checked in with. Who was most definitely this guy. Now I'm getting somewhere. What? How would I push her? Oh!
You know, that's like. Hold it!
Yeah, I know.
Plus, it's like pressing, yeah. So it's one.
Oh, the music changed. That's not good. This is it. All or nothing. Time to do a little vlog. No use playing dumb! If you don't talk, I'm taking this info to the press.
What?
Even though he should have been witness to the murder, your little friend was missing. I'm sure the press would have a field day with his reputation.
I'll talk. You win, lawyer.
Yes. Man, that felt good. It's great to be alive.
You're kind of hot here.
I want to say this kind
of. Why are you pumping your fist in the air?
Well, because. That was the first time you noticed I was being quiet? Interesting.
No, I'm just calling you out on it.
Okay. Oh, you mean too quiet. Now, tell me about the man you were with.
He's my boss! Red White, the president of the information gathering conglomerate Blue Corp.
That was fun.
Red, white, and blue?
Blue? What do you mean blue?
He's the president of Blue Corp. You just said that.
God damn it! I'm so bad at paying attention sometimes. Information gathering?
You could call it a detective agency.
So this is the man that was with you. Wait, what? So this is the man that was with you the night of the murder.
I'm scared to talk. I don't want to end up like her.
Her? Oh. It's okay. I'll just ask Mr. White himself. Can you tell me where Blue Corp is located? Of course. Not gonna tell. Mr. White, at last. A lead on this guy. April May couldn't have done it. That leaves him.
time to take action. Help voice. Discard. Yes! No more elephant inventory slot. I wonder if there's any more things I can say. Wait, the other thing got removed? I don't even remember what it was.
I don't either.
I thought you would. Oh boy, here we go. This is not gonna end up well for us, probably. Oh! That's interesting.
It's the cowboy!
Yep.
Dot.
What's with the surreal decor? Should I do it?
Alright. Let me do it. I haven't talked in a while. Welcome! Please furnish me with the title of your personage.
I like how you said you haven't talked in a while, even though you just did. Anyway. What the?
In a comfortable voice.
Okay.
Your name! What's your name? I was just equivocally asking the title that you go by.
Right. Phoenix Wright. Inquirably?
So Wright, is it? Right, I see. Splendiferous. Perhaps I have intimidated you with my gigantesque vocabulary.
What is this guy's problem?
I'm Red White, CEO of Blue Corp. You know, corporate expansion official. My business dealings bring me into contact with the elite of the elite. So I'm afraid I am not used to conversing with the worthily challenged.
What the freaking...
You're so quiet I can barely hear you.
Okay, I'll go again. What a fruitcake.
Let me guess. You're an attorney, fresh out of law school, are you not? That's the only explanation for why you would come to meet me like this.
What does he mean by that?
No matter. So, what business does a mighty lawyer have with a man such as myself?
Yikes. This guy's arrogance feature is off the scale. Well, that's interesting. I want to investigate this thing first because it looks like it has a penis. I'm guessing that's unintentional. A statue of the man holding up the world. The Blue Corp sign certainly stands out enough. The model for the man is, of course, Mr. White.
But probably too futificus for you to appreciate, correct?
I think it's a little too judicious for just about anyone to appreciate.
It's basically like the statue of Atlas. So
is that
and the statue?
Is that a toenail? It's a big toenail. Anyway, what do you say, Eric?
Nothing.
I'm guessing this is supposed to be a desk.
My, my. This is quite the thing.
It is marked on my body, see? Well, does it squeak round at your not inspire you?
I haven't seen this somewhere.
Haven't I seen this somewhere?
Haven't I seen this somewhere? Is this a replica?
Ridiculousity. I have no interest in anything but originals.
Did you say ridiculously? Anyway.
That right there is a bona fide original worth $5 million for sure.
Question mark trophy. An impressive lineup of trophies. Judges special runner-up, best participation. Judges cooperation award, special good try prize. The words judges and special kind of stand out. Alright, I think I've checked almost everything except for that pot right there. I guess I can't check that. Oh, the window. This is the top floor of a 20-story building. The view is quite presidential. What kind of company is Blue Corp anyway?
Excellent question. We buy and sell various kinds of information. We are a company of the future. You might say we are the future.
Sell information?
In just 10 years, I built this business up into the grand office you see now. In case you were wondering, Blue Corp was named after the color blue. I, Red White of Blue Corp, as founder and CEO, named it so. And why, you ask? Because I like the color blue, of course. Fantabulistic, is it not? Yet he wears pink.
So? I don't really see a problem with that. Miss May is an employee of Blue Corp, is she not?
Pink isn't the usual color we have, and if blue is his favorite, then he'd be wearing blue. Well, pink is the usual color for suits. I mean. Correct. She was my secretariat.
Well, he does. Wait. Are those supposed to be like diamonds as buttons? Interesting.
Guess so. What a shock it was to hear what she has done.
What she has done? You mean the wiretap?
Indeed. She is paid to answer phones. Tapping them is not in her job description. She does gather information for us as part of her duties. But I assure you, we do not condone illegal methods. It is ineffable that she would do this.
Sounds like he's trying to turn Miss May into a scapegoat. I don't even know what that means, but I'm gonna pretend that I know. Alright, here we go. On the night of the murder, were you in April May's hotel room?
Who can say? I seldom pay attention to mundane details such as time and place. My motto is, don't worry, be happy.
Still, Mr. White. The hotel bellboy has stated on the record that he does remember you very clearly.
No matter. The bellboy can't say what he pleases. I still won't talk to you. If you want me to speak, put me on the witness stand. Although I doubt you'd be capable of doing that.
It raises a good question, actually. Why didn't the prosecution call him as a witness? He should have been seen the same thing as April May.
Oh ho ho! The police! The courts! To me, they are mere toys. Playthings for my amusement.
Now I can ask the painting?
That's weird. Yep.
There's something that's been bothering me.
Yeah, what might that be?
That big painting on the wall over there. Say, when did you get that painting?
No idea. I forgot.
I've seen that painting before. Yesterday. In fact, it just says it anyway. Why do I find that painting here today?
Mr. Wong, was it?
Right.
It appears you do not fully grasp your position here. I ask again, who are you?
A lawyer. A lawyer.
No. My feeble friends. A mere lawyer. Worth nothing. Zilch. Zippo. Nada. Just like that sorry excuse for an attorney. Grody Burger.
What? He punched me.
Well, Mr. Lawyer, what will you do, eh? Charge me with assault?
It's a good idea.
Charge away, I welcome it. For it is you who will be found guilty.
What?
In my exposition, the police, the courts, they all do my bidding.
So you say. But I wonder, is that kind of control really possible?
I don't expect you to understand. It is a world beyond your comprehension. I got the money.
I think the word is
compensation. Compensation.
Oh, okay. I got money. Yep, that's what I was thinking. Exactly.
You came here from Grody Burgers, I presume.
Mr. Grossberg's. Yes.
Then you must ask him, why is it that this painting of his hangs here? Perhaps then he will tell you. Perhaps he will explain how a man can live life purely for personal profit. Go now, skedaddle. There is nothing more to discuss.
Very well.
So I guess we go to Grossberg's.
What if I send him his own painting?
That's a photograph.
Photograph.
Would you be kind enough to cease your inane chattering and vacate the premises? Let me put in the language you are sure to understand. Shut up and get out. I have nothing more to say.
Very well then. Wait, I can check the chair?
I think that's the painting.
Wait, why can't I check this all again?
I don't know.
Let's see if there's anything
different.
Maybe
he'll stop you from...
Oh. Why does white have it now? It's not hard to imagine if you lost the lens. It's just the same thing.
It said something different.
It did?
Yeah, it said he probably strong-armed them into giving it to him.
That one, I think, was the same.
Yeah.
Isn't this supposed to be this? Thing. Yeah, that's the same thing.
Uh-huh.
Wait, the window's the only thing? Weird. I thought he was gonna knock me out or something when that happened, but I guess not.
He just beat the shit out of you.
I thought he only punched me one time.
Yeah, he just punched you.
I guess I'll go back here.
Why not Grossberg?
Wait, what? Apparently, Miss May is in questioning. I doubt they'll let me talk to her today. That's interesting.
Alright, let's see. I know that it was all of gold.
I don't think he noticed me standing here. Maybe I should clear my throat?
Okay, let me.
Oh, jump in the Hoosapatch! Oh, you!
What's wrong? You look so pensive, like an old man at the end of his days.
I'm not senile yet. I was just thinking about this whole mess.
Something's really bothering me. That much is clear. Wanna see? Yep, same thing. Well, the picture is not there anymore. Mm. Oh wait, I don't have anything. Except for the picture that I took from him. So you came to see the trial?
Yeah. Yes, I did. Something was bothering me all last night, you see. Couldn't get a wink of sleep. I love gold.
What is... Really? What was that?
Well, you see, it's just... me and sister, that poor girl. My boy, I owe you my thanks, truly. I don't know what I would have done if things had gone poorly for the girl. Yeah, why'd you refuse?
I asked before, but why did you refuse her request for defense? I think I have a right to know.
Hey, White, Mr. White? No, no, I'm sorry. It's just, I need more time to think about it, my boy.
He does seem troubled about something. I'm starting to have a feeling. I know what it is. So, I paid Blue Corp a visit.
I see.
Mr. Grossberg. I have to admit, something has been bothering me.
Oh, what is it? Well, with it, my boy.
You see, it's just... All three of these are pretty... Well, these two are probably the most important.
I don't know, maybe the painting?
I thought it was strange. Here was Maya, your own apprentice's little sister, in desperate need. Accused of killing her own sister, no less. And you wouldn't take the case. I finally realized why. You and Red White are connected. He's... your lover. Mr. White has some... Oh.
I love that Red White and Blue cock.
Mr. White has something on you, doesn't he? Blackmail.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Mr. Grossberg, sir. There was a giant painting hanging right there the other day, was there not? The one you said you had no intention of parting with. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Well, I saw it today. It was in the CEO's office at Blue Corp, Red White's office.
So, you noticed. I suppose I should have guessed you would. It is a large painting.
Mr. Grossberg, tell me what happened.
Red White is a man who makes his living through intimidation. Blue Corp is a company that excels in finding people's weaknesses, I'm afraid. I've been paying them for 15 years now.
What? 15 years?
All because of the DL6 incident, as you may have guessed.
Name in the back of those photographs.
As you suspected, I could not stand in defense of Maya because of this. White would have destroyed me if I did.
So that's the condition.
It is hard for me to tell you this, my boy. But arresting Red White will be nigh on impossible.
Impossible? Why?
He has information on everyone. It gives him an iron grip. He owns judges, attorneys, prosecutors, police, and politicians.
What?
They are bound, unable to harm, to do harm to themselves, and therefore to him. Don't look at me like that. What you see is nothing more than the weight of many years.
What is the DL6 incident?
DL6 is nothing more than the sorting code the police gave the case. It was 15 years ago now. I received a request from a medium, a spirit medium. Her name was Misty Fay.
Fay.
Indeed. She was Mia's mother. She had been investigating a murder at the behest of the police. And she failed. As a result, the police called her a fraud.
This is what Mayo was talking about the other day.
I did all I could for her, and in the end, cleared her of wrongdoing. That murder case, however, remains unsolved to this day. That case is the DL6 incident.
But why were you-
Sorry.
It's fine. Hold on, I'm gonna breathe real quick.
Yeah, I know our feeling.
But why were you blackmailed over this, Mr. Grossberg?
The DL6 incident was top secret at the time. It made sense. The police didn't want people to know they were using a medium. They couldn't let people know. But one person found out. I told him.
You told White?
He offered me witches. It isn't an embarrassment to me now. Because I talked, the police were mocked far and wide. In secret, they began looking for the one who sold them out. Of course, White heard about it, and he came to me. Only this time, the offer was blackmail.
I see.
White controls the law of this country as he sees fit. Yet, if you would still challenge him, have a close look at Mia's office.
Mia's office?
She followed his every move for years. She may have recorded something of what she found.
Huh. Well, that's useful.
Back to the office! Fay & Co.
It's funny. Looking at this room, it seems so normal. Hard to imagine a murder took place here.
Yeah, murder of your hot boss.
Wonder if he really thinks of her that way. Well,
I know.
Why not anymore?
Yeah, she's
you
fucking
know.
Dead.
Mr. Grossberg said there would be clues. Maybe I should have another look. Okay. Did I check this? No, you can't check that. The books. Of course. All the cases the chief ever worked on are filled here, or filed here. They're in alphabetical order. Let's take a look. Which file should I look at? AI. Let's see if there is an A record in this file. Wait, let's see if there's an A record in this file that catches my eye.
If there's a record that catches my eye.
Mm-hmm. A, B, F. Misty Faye. That's Mia and Maya's mother. Should I take a look?
Okay, should I do the voice?
Do you want to? Or
I mean it's Mia.
It's just text, so. Sure, go ahead.
I don't know. Okay,
Let me think.
I have tarnished the Fae name, leaving only these words, my mother vanished. I was determined to find the one who had made my mother blame herself in this way. Using the power that's once in my family, I held an audience with the dead. Finally, the names of two men surfaced. One was Marvin Grossberg, a lawyer who sold my mother's information for witches. The other was the man who sold that information to the press. This parasite who makes his fortune on threats and coercion. His name is...
The record stops there. So, Mia knew Grossberg. I mean,
of course they did.
No, I mean, I was gonna say, he, like...
He was... She was his apprentice.
Yeah, that's not what I meant, though. I mean, I'm pretty sure... I mean, what other man would there be that has to do with threats? Let me see here.
Wait, maybe
it's not checked... It's not checked out? Weird. Let's see. J through S. Nothing much in here. Maybe I'll just skim of this? Well, no
no harm in flipping through a bit. Yes. Biggest part's here. At the end of S. Suicide. Ew. She has a collection of suicide reports. This politician, policeman. There's writing on most of these in pencil. Right? This is Mia's handwriting. Wait. I get it. Mia thought he was involved in these suicides. White drove them all to. I can use these newspaper clippings. Let's find the most disturbing one. Sorry, hang on. Give me a second. Wait, wasn't there one left?
Yeah.
Huh. It's just weird that's not checked out. T. U. I know. W. White. The entire W section is missing. Was it taken? That was it? That's surprising.
Yeah. I guess it was taken by a certain Mr. White.
Yeah, huh. No way, I'm just gonna... Wait, hold on.
I guess present that to either Boasberg.
That's what I was thinking, but like... I feel like... It feels like... That's...
Well, aren't you persistent?
Sorry, but there's something I have to ask you.
Mr. Lawyer... I really hate having to repeat myself. But it seems the message has not yet penetrated your thick skull. Stop bothering me. If you try my patience further, I fear a nasty accident may occur. Do I make myself clear?
Transparent. Are there more options? There are. Weird. This won't count. Mr. White, see this? It's an article describing suicide of a politician. He was embezzling secret government funds. Then, one day, word got leaked to the press. The very next day, he took his own life.
And this concerns me how?
I found this article in Mia's office.
Miss Mia?
She had a file filled with articles like this. Every one of them was labeled with a single word. Mr. White, I know what you did to this politician.
Blackmail.
I was gonna say bribed, actually, but yeah, I was...
Blackmail's his thing!
You were blackmailing him.
Blackmail?
I thought it was both. Not just him, either. You were threatening and... coursing hundreds of others. You were involved in all of the suicide cases that Mia investigated. This company is built on blackmail. I'm right, aren't I?
What a bizarre accusation. Mr. Wong, what is it that you should be doing now? Investigating me? No, 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 I think not. You should be searching for the one who killed Miss Mia.
His office. Hello.
Mr. Wong will be leaving now.
Yes, sir. I'll send someone. Wait a second, Mr. White. You're wrong, Mr. White.
Excuse me.
What I should be doing now is going after you.
Just what are you insinuating?
Mia was on to you. She was keeping tabs. For this reason, you had April May tapping her phone. Then, Mia was murdered, and all the documents about you mysteriously disappeared. So the culprit would be... Even a child could work it out, Mr. White. You did it. Secretary's office.
Escort for Mr. Wong. Instead, please contact me to the public prosecutor's office.
Of course, sir. A moment, please. White, that's you. What are you calling me at a time like this?
To be me, since I'm prosecution. Hello, Chief Prosecutor. Oh. I've changed my mind. I want to testify tomorrow. What's this about? The Maya Fey case. I witnessed the murder, you see. And thus, as a very important witness, I would like to testify. What? What? Why not? I thought you said you didn't want to go to court. Quite rude. I told you I changed my mind, didn't I? Oh, and one other thing. Send the police over here right away. The man is standing right in front of me. He looks dazed, but could be violent. What? What man? Are you even listening? The executioner. The hatchet man, the liquidator, the killer man.
What?
Mr. White, this isn't another one of those. Chief Prosecutor, I do not believe you are in a position to freely offer your opinions to me, correct? I'm telling you to send the police now. Did I not tell you, Mr. Wong? You are me a lawyer. As was Miss Mia.
How dare you!
I'll point the finger at you, and you will be tried as Miss Mia's killer. The case is as good as settled. No lawyer of any worth will defend you. I have friends in the local lawyers association, you see. You'll be given a lawyer so stupendously inept that they make even you a competent.
I feel faint.
Detective Gumshoe, reporting, sir. Ah, but Harry Butts.
Right, actually, Phoenix, right. And my friend's name is Larry.
Oh, right. Sorry, pal. Butts was that murderer, right?
Oh my goodness.
Detective Gumshoe. I present to you the man who killed Miss Mia Fey. What? Take this despicable human being into custody. Farewell, Mr. Wong.
Oh boy. What have Tai got into now?
You've committed a murder.
Well, yeah. Well, I mean, not yet, but I can't believe it's only been a day since the first trial. My trial begins tomorrow. Wright's going to set a trap for me. The prosecution will be on it, of course. Edgeworth included. An attorney was assigned to me by the state yesterday. I refused. I had an idea. Wright! Mr. Wright! Oh, Maya. Great. They let you out of detention.
Just now, yes. It's all thanks to you.
Now I'm afraid we switch places.
What? You mean you?
Explained what happened to me.
I don't believe it. How many people does that man need to destroy before he's satisfied? My mother, my sister, and now you! This has gone too far! Mr. Wright, please tell me, is there anything I can do?
Well...
I guess Chameon is the most...
I mean, who else would be? Maybe I'm gonna make the test. Alright, you can be my defense lawyer tomorrow.
Alright.
Huh?
Leave it to me. I am Mia's sister after all. Lawyership runs in our blood.
Isn't it ghost powers that ran in your blood? What happened if I clicked another option, I wonder? Do you think it would have just happened anyway, Eric? Anyway.
I better...
Yes, he's not.
Okay.
I better run to the bookstore and pick up a copy of Law for Rookies.
Wait. Wait.
What?
I'm kidding. It was a joke.
No way.
No, really. I was kidding. But thanks. It's good to know that you're on my side. Really isn't anything you could do for me anyway.
But I can't just sit here and do nothing. I've got to give that man a piece of my mind.
Just a piece? Okay. Then, come to the trial tomorrow.
Okay, I'll be there. I'll show them a thing or two.
Times may change, yet with a crime, it's the same old story. In fact, it's gotten worse. Lengthy court proceedings are no longer realistic. Beginning a few years ago, a limit of 3 days was put on initial court trials. Almost all finish in a gay, most of the guilty verdicts. I never thought I would end up in the defendant's chair myself for this case. With the true culprit appearing as the star witness. This is it. Tomorrow it's me or him.
White versus white.
Oh, right versus white. I was like, what? What are you talking about? What?
Do you want to continue or calling it a day?
Call it a day. I'm actually kind of tired from all that talking, believe it or not.
I know that feel.
I mean, to be fair, I wasn't probably supposed to be up yet. And I wasn't really ready for this, but I kind of just did anyway.
Thomas, you started at 1.
Yeah, but wait. I said I wasn't ready for it.
What do you mean you're not...
I guess it was probably 5 days ago.
You sleep in too late.
Well...
Yes.
No.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, what does that make you then? What does that make you then? You tell me.
The latest I slept in was like 11.
Hilarious.
You, on the other hand.
What, you're gonna say like 5 a.m.? Is that what you're gonna say? Go on. I'm waiting.
Are you still streaming?
I didn't stop yet. I didn't think it was that bad to talk about.
Okay, whatever. 3 p.m.
You really think I'd do that?
I believe you have done that.
Alright, hold on.
Or 1 or 2. You definitely slept until 1.
Good night. Well, why didn't good night? Good. End of the stream.
Good night.